Em investigações iniciais da UNRWA, Agência da ONU de Assistência aos Refugiados da Palestina, sugerem que a artilharia israelense foi responsável por atingir uma de suas escolas no norte da Faixa de Gaza. No momento do impacto, o edifício servia de abrigo para cerca de 3.300 pessoas.
We had repeatedly informed the Israeli Defense Forces about this particular school. We had notified it because it was important to protect it, and also because the people who were in this school were there because they had received instructions from the Israeli Defense Forces to leave the areas that they lived in, and therefore they were sheltered in that premise, hoping and expecting there to be safe and protected. And the fact that they weren't is unacceptable. And in the strongest possible terms, I issue today a condemnation of the Israeli shelling of this school as representing a serious violation of international law. We are here in a situation where UNRWA finds itself dealing now with 220,000 people in 82 of its schools throughout the Gaza Strip. And I think the world just has to understand that when we hear 200,000 people in 82 schools, maybe that sounds like something orderly. Maybe that sounds like something sustainable. Well, it isn't. Right now, there is no place in Gaza where civilians feel safe. Not even in what should be the sanctity of UN school buildings. And in that sense, the world has failed these people, and it has to be expressed in the strongest possible terms.
Nesta quinta-feira, o comissário-geral da agência também visitou o centro pediátrico de um dos principais hospitais da cidade de Gaza. No local, ele testemunhou de perto o sofrimento infligido aos jovens palestinos pelos bombardeios de Israel.
Young Youssef, who is 5 months old and lying in the bed, victim of yesterday's shelling at Jabalia School, is a person like each and every one of us, a child like each and every child in the world that should never have to be lying in this bed. Responsibility for protection of civilians in times of war lies with the armed parties themselves. The Israeli Defense Forces, fighting forces inside Gaza, are the ones that have the responsibility to ensure protection of civilians. And the international community has a responsibility politically to intervene to stop abuses when the fighting forces cannot guarantee that and do not do that themselves. I cannot understand why the additional measures of precaution that are required and protection that are required by armed forces, and in this particular case by the Israeli Defense Forces, cannot be improved on. I cannot understand it.
Centro de Informação das Nações Unidas para o Brasil, UNIC Rio.